Hello everyone. So in this lecture we will start with the open set, and before this we have learned the definition of interior point and neighborhood. Okay, so in both the definition, the only difference is one is a property of sets and one is a property of points, that is an interior point. Okay, so by using the interior point and neighborhood, both the things can be used to define open set. Okay, so I will define first by the neighborhood, and then we will look at what is the relation of an interior point with an open set. All right, so a set, let S be a set. So let a set S is said to be an open set if S is a neighborhood of NBD of each of its points, and each of its points, that is an immediate, we must recall that what is the definition of neighborhood, that is because it is talking about the each of its point. Therefore, for every x, therefore I can write that for all x belongs to S, there should be an open interval, for example, let's say I, such that x belongs to I and I must be a subset of x. But this definition has to be valid for all the points of S. Alright, therefore we will say that S is neighborhood of what? X. And for all x this should satisfy. Therefore I will say that for each point I will get a neighborhood. So we will say that S is neighborhood of each of its point. Therefore, so I can choose I if epsilon bigger than 0. Therefore, x minus epsilon and x plus epsilon, that is an I, and it should be a subset of S. That we have defined the notion of an interval in terms of epsilon. Alright, so this is the definition in the terms of neighborhood. And if we have defined that an interior point is, what is an interior point? If any point X is said to be an interior point, if there exists an interval, if there exists a neighborhood, not for an interval, a neighborhood such that neighborhood must be a subset of S. Therefore, I will say that every point of an open set is an interior point. Because when S is neighborhood of each of its points, then the condition of interior points is automatically satisfied. Therefore, each point of an open set is an interior point. Alright, it means that if S is open, then S interior, so I will denote by interior as this S dot S small circle is equal to S. So it means that whenever S is open, so this condition is if and only if, so I will write again that S is open set if and only if the interior of S is what? It should be equal to S. That is the, so you can use this definition whenever you want to check an open set. Alright, so now we will look at few examples, that is the first example I will choose from the number system itself, that is set n, that is set of natural numbers. So what are natural numbers? I will write 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. These are the natural numbers. So if I want to check that n is open or not, is n, the set of natural number, open. So I will check n is open or not. So for that, I will locate the points on the number line. So my number line is this, real numbers. So if I locate a point, for example 1, and 1 iska interior point hoga ya nahi, to 1 ke around ek aisa open interval milna chahiye, kyunki humko ye pata karna hai ki kya iske, kyunki agar isko open prove karna hai to humko ye dekhna hoga ki isme jitne bhi points hain wo sare interior points hain ya nahi. तो सारे इंटीरियर पॉइंट्स चेक करना, तो हम 1 बाय 1 पहले 1 को देखते हैं. तो 1 माइनस एप्सिलॉन एंड 1 प्लस एप्सिलॉन, अगेन आई विल फॉर्म एन ओपन इंटरवल बिकॉज़ आई हैव टू चेक एन इंटीरियर पॉइंट. सो 1 माइनस ओ एप्सिलॉन एंड 1 प्लस एप्सिलॉन, नेचुरली 1 इज कंटेंड इन दिस एंड दिस इज सबसेट ऑफ n और नॉट. सो इट इज नॉट अ सबसेट ऑफ n, देयरफॉर इट इज नॉट एन इंटीरियर पॉइंट, देयरफॉर 1 इज नॉट एन इंटीरियर पॉइंट. And each of its point, each point of n must be an interior point if n has to be open. अगर n को open होना है तो उसका हर point जरूरी है कि वो interior point होना चाहिए. तो 1 तो नहीं है, तो fail करने के लिए तो एक ही काफी है. Therefore n is not open. Set of natural number is not an open set because each of its point is not an interior point. In the similar way, हम set of integers के लिए prove कर सकते हैं, okay? But again we will look at, तो integers के लिए कर सकते हैं, rational number के लिए कर सकते हैं, तो फिर से हमारे पास वही आएगा कि जो rational number होगा, उसके around एक point होगा, जैसे एक rational number हमने choose किया, for example 1 by 3, तो again 1 by 3 minus epsilon, 1 by 3 plus epsilon, it should not be subset of Q. Why? Because this interval will contain irrational as well. Therefore, ये Q का subset नहीं होगा. तो इसका मतलब क्या होगा कि 1 by 3 is not an interior point of Q. 1 by 3 is not an interior point of set of rational number. In the similar way, therefore Z is not open, Q is not open. Z, Q ये सब not open है, they are not open. In the similar way, Q complement is not open. Q complement is not open. But R is open, the set of real numbers. Because any real number you choose on the number line, for example, A belongs to R I have chosen. Therefore, A minus epsilon and A plus epsilon will be contained in R. And naturally, this interval will contain A. Therefore, for general point, we have shown that this interval for epsilon bigger than 0, you can write. Everywhere, wherever you use epsilon, you should write that what is the epsilon, the value of the epsilon. So it is positive. The epsilon is positive. So A belongs to A minus epsilon, A plus epsilon, and subset of R. Therefore, R is open. And what about phi? An empty set. What about an empty set? Empty set is also open. ऐसा क्यों है? Empty set open इसलिए है क्योंकि हमको क्या प्रूव करना है कि each of its point is an interior point and when empty set does not contain any point तो आप interior किसको show करेंगे? There is no point in it, therefore the definition is satisfied. Therefore I will say that phi and r are open. Phi and r, the set of real numbers and the empty set, are two open set. R में तो हमें clearly identify हो जाता है, but phi में clearly identify नहीं होता है because it does not contain any point. Therefore, the definition is validated automatically. Alright, in the, अब हम एक और example देख सकते हैं, जैसे, मान लीजिए हमने ये example लिया, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and so on. Again, हम उसको number line पे plot करेंगे, तो हम फिर से ये show करेंगे, कि इसके जो भी points हैं, वो interior points नहीं हैं. Interior points नहीं हैं, क्यों नहीं हैं? Because 1 लिया, 1 by 2 लिया, 1 by 3 लिया, आप कोई भी छोटा member ले लें. जरूरी नहीं है कि हम ये ले सकते हैं, कोई भी पॉइंट ले सकते हैं. तो 1 by 3, तो ईच ऑफ इट्स पॉइंट मस्ट बी एन इंटीरियर पॉइंट. तो हम फिर से कोई भी हम इंटरवल बनाएंगे, 1 by 3 माइनस एप्सिलॉन, 1 by 3 फॉर एग्जांपल हमने चूज किया, तो 1 by 3 माइनस एप्सिलॉन बनाया, 1 by 3 प्लस एप्सिलॉन बनाया. क्या ये किसका सबसेट है? अगर मान लीजिए इस सेट का नाम हमने दिया कैपिटल एक्स, तो क्या ये एक्स का सबसेट है? तो नहीं होगा. Why it is not subset of x? Because 1 by 3 minus epsilon, तो epsilon की value अगर हम 1 by 10 choose कर लें for example, तो 1 by 3 minus 1 by 10 और 1 by 3 plus 1 by 10, इसके बीच में हमें infinitely many points मिल जाएंगे जो कि x का subset नहीं होगा. इसके बीच में between 1 by 3 minus 1 by 10 and 1 by 3 plus 1 by 10, 1 by 10, तो ये properly contained इसमें नहीं होगा, किसमें? x में नहीं होगा. therefore कम से कम में एक epsilon ऐसा मिला जिसके लिए हमारे पास जो neighborhood बन रहा है, जो interval बन रहा है, that is not properly contained in x, totally contained in x. therefore it is not open, it is also not open set. okay, so यहाँ पर हमारे पास जो हमने examples किए हैं, तो ये examples हमें mind में भी होने चाहिए कि ये सारे open set नहीं हैं. alright, तो अब हम next turn पे देखेंगे कि open set की कुछ जो important theorems हैं उनको discuss करेंगे. for example, अगर union of open sets हैं तो क्या होगा, intersection of open sets हैं तो क्या होगा.